being ultimate champion of Mortal Kombat, so we must throw down! Never! I will defeat you, Skeletor! You've made me incredibly angry! Well, unfortunately, somewhere else I need to cool off! Beware the mighty dropkick of Skeletor! Oh! How long have you guys been watching? I was just, practicing for my final Mortal Kombat battle against, He-Man. Yeah, that's what I was doing. Anyway, Skeletor has pirated Shane's channel once again. Now, since the Mortal Kombat trailer was reintroduced, people have been sending me messages. Skeletor, would you please do a review of Mortal Kombat? We know you're a huge fan of gratuitous violence, so please, tell us what you think of this new film. Apparently, this film was inspired by a video game of the same name. Now, I have never played Mortal Kombat video game, although I would like to. Now, I know the video game is like this.
Scorpion, win.
Looks pretty neat. I totally want to play this. But the important question is, what do I, Skeletor, feel about the film? Now, I've been told that every single video game movie that has ever been attempted has not been good. And I did watch this one, and I have to say that, unfortunately, it's not that good. Does that mean I didn't find enjoyment in it? Hey, I'm Skeletor. There's gratuitous violence, fight sequences, and a whole lot of blood and gore. Of course I liked it. But was it a good film? Was it a good piece of cinema? Well, Martin Scorsese would say no. And he'd be right. Let's talk about the plot. There might be some spoilers, mind you. So I get the sense that if you were a fan of the video game and knew the characters in depth, you would probably be far better off as understanding what was happening than a noob like me who has no clue what the hell or who these people are. For example, the whole movie starts with Sub-Zero hiding behind a tree with his ninja clan, although he, for some reason, wasn't dressed like a ninja, but everyone else was, deciding to pick on a poor farmer family in Japan. I didn't understand why. See, the movie didn't explain that to me. Now I know people are like, well, that's Sub-Zero and that's Scorpion and they hate each other because of their clans. I only found that out after because the movie did not tell me this. So I went in thinking, why is he picking on that poor guy? Why did he have to attack his whole family and then killing that farmer guy, who we all know turns into Scorpion later on? So his motivation I didn't quite understand. I will say that fight was great. It was one of my favorite fights. I need to get one of those chains with a knife at the end of it. He-Man would have a hard time with that. I gotta learn that whole trick. He-Man, get over here! Although, if I did do that to He-Man, he probably would have just tossed me around, as he always does. Anyway, at that moment, some Thunder Lightning guy comes in and rescues the last child, and I guess rescues her so that he could continue the bloodline. Okay, makes sense. So fast forward 300 years, and now the new heir to this bloodline is a very, very unlikable character called Cole. The name, however, does suit his character, as he was nothing more than a lump of coal. Now, we introduce to this guy, and he gets his butt handed to him in some MMA fight, and we're supposed to root for this guy. Wonderful introduction to our hero. Can you imagine if Indiana Jones lost? Like, they don't understand that first impressions are pretty important. It gets you to really like your character, be jazzed up about him. And the first time you see him, his daughter is telling him how to fight for some reason, and he loses. Which is pretty much his whole character. He's not good. I don't get why he's even in the film. Then we are introduced to Jax, who, you know, he apparently is seeking out Cole because Cole has a tattoo he was born with. It says he's going to participate in Mortal Kombat to defend your realm from being conquered. Which I really need to figure out how to do that. Maybe that would work in Eternia. Nah, as much as I'd love to set up a Mortal Kombat situation, He-Man would just dominate. Nah, would be no point. Anyway, so apparently there's a tournament that decides the fate of the realms, and Underworld Realm has won this 9 times. One more time, and according to the rules of Mortal Kombat, and I guess the universe, they get to conquer the universe. Fine, so these champions are decided randomly, I guess. I don't know. We don't know how they're decided or why. They just are. It's some random spin of the wheel. And if they weren't randomly selected, I would like them to tell us why they were selected. So this guy, Jax, he's been spying on Cole, and then he sees a Sub-Zero now, 300 years later, looking quite young. Might I add, we don't know why he has not aged, but he hasn't aged. He is seeking out Cole to defeat him. I mean, really, if he just looked at his record and been like, this guy sucks, why am I wasting precious time? There's probably other fighters far better than this jerk. But I guess because he knows he belongs to the rival clan, so he has to finish him off. Again, we don't get told that. We're just supposed to know this because of the game. So he goes after him and his family, and then Jax Ex Machina saves him. Sub-Zero rips his arms off. Pretty awesome sequence, actually. You know, throws his arms in a fight and then they all shattered, which I thought was pretty awesome. Although, his fall down into the ground reminded me of Titanic, and I was like, there's no way he survived that fall. He looked like he hit his head on a barbed steel rod, and he survived, but whatever. Well, fun, this movie is quite nonsensical. Before he went, he told Cole, hey, lump of coal, do me a favor. Go seek out Sonya at this trailer park somewhere. And so, lump of coal decided to go to seek out Sonya, and, upon meeting Sonya, Lump of Coal loses another battle. It's just fun to see your hero get his ass handed to him every chance he gets. It's so fun. I don't understand this character and why I'm even caring. So she defeats him, and then we walk into her trailer and we see my favorite character all tied up. Kano, some Aussie foul-mouth, and I like him. He reminds me of me. His foul-mouth says whatever is on his mind, and his treachery knows no bounds. I like treacherous characters. Well, I'm a treacherous character myself. I'm always supporting the treacherous characters. And it just so happens that Kano is the most charismatic character in the whole film. So she tells Cole, Lump of Cole, about the tournament and anybody with that mark, which unfortunately she has no mark, so then I don't understand why she's so interested in this. But she decides to seek out and become part of this tournament, even though she knows she can't. Suddenly, some lizard reptile creature who's invisible decides to attack, and he's very ineffectual, because even though he's got the element of surprise and looks pretty menacing and strong, he really sucked balls, as he was pretty easily defeated by Kano, of all people. The only person Kano defeats is Reptile, in a really awesome way, mind you. Rips his heart out and goes and says, ah! Which was awesome, I have to say. So that was actually not bad of a sequence. Some people didn't like it, but I thought it was ingenious, him putting the flare onto him so he could see him. I thought that was pretty badass. Anyway, so they all travel, tra-la, tra-la, to the Shaolin Temple, which apparently only Kano knew about, and only decided to tell them because he believed that a woman who lived in a trailer park had $2 million to spare. Not a very bright fellow, this Kano. I like him, but not bright. They head to this Shaolin Temple, where they find their friend Jax lying there. How he got there, I don't know. And he's got apparently some metal arms attached to him. I guess people in Shaolin are very technical savvy. They live in a cave with torches, but they don't even have Wi-Fi, for heaven's sake. But somehow they managed to give him metal arms that worked. The only explanation was, well, we searched the realms for technology, and this is the best we could find. Fine, whatever. Next, they meet a bunch of other guys named Liu Kang and Kung Lao. From what I understand, Liu Kang is actually supposed to be the main hero, but they opted for a lump of coal instead. Now, I don't understand why, as I really liked Liu Kang. I thought he was a far better hero than lump of coal. Oh, and they introduced Raiden. Did some exposition talking about the tournament and blah, blah, blah. Although his accent was really heavy. Speaking of lump of coal, the actor was horrible. And I didn't understand half the words that he was saying. So anyway, they are doing some eating and training and talking, and this was just boring me to death. So all of a sudden, Shang Tsung appears, who's apparently the main villain. I don't know anything about this character. They don't explain much about him. I don't know why he cares about the Earth Realm, what his desires are. I don't even really understand his power. The movie didn't explain that to me, so I don't even know what he does, why he's so powerful, and why I should fear him. I mean, we have a god on our side, and they have I don't know why I should fear him, or any of these people. In fact, the only person they made us fear was Sub-Zero. That's it. Nobody else was really that imposing to me. So anyway, Raiden puts up this barrier and says, not yet. We're not fighting yet. This is not fair, and we can't fight. So the bad guys piss off. And they do this training thing where they're trying to unwrap their inner power, which somehow this tattoo gives them inner power. And they train, and the first person to get his power was Kano, because he was embarrassed by Liu Kang, who just kept sweeping his foot, which I know apparently is something to do with the video game. but it looked absolutely ridiculous. Like, why is he even chosen to fight as he was beaten up by everyone except one lizard? So he unwraps his power, finally, because he was embarrassed, and it was a laser eye. Yay! And Lump of Coal still can't unwrap his power, and he looks absolutely ridiculous, loses all the fights. They find out that Sonya has no tattoo, therefore she's incapable of joining the tournament. Jax tries to fight with his horrible, robotic, crappy arm, and he doesn't do well. He looks horrible too. And now we're looking at the humans going, I don't know. I don't think you can win this. Cole then pisses off because he's upset. He's all pouty because he can't fight and doesn't know what he's doing there. And so he leaves to go to his family. Fine, I was like, yay! He's gone! Don't let the portal door hit your ass on the way out, Cole. So Cole goes back to his family. Now, for some reason, the villains think that he's still important to the plot. So they send this massive, monstrous Hulk guy called Goro with multiple arms. And I know that Goro is like one of the main bosses in Mortal Kombat. So why they sent the main boss to have a fight in the middle of a parking lot with a nobody like Cole, I don't understand. But they did. And they fought. That's when Cole unlocked his ability, which was a really convenient plot armor, very good. I still don't understand his power. Now, it was explained to me that his power is apparently he takes punches, Black Panther does, and then eventually it just absorbs the power and it becomes part of his strength, but it was never really explained well, so whatever. So eventually he gets these really cool, so he gets a baton in one end and a dagger knife thing on the other. So, and of course, as he gets his power, he easily defeats Goro, and then he thinks he's worthy and goes back to the tournament. Yay! Cole is back, everyone. Wonderful. I couldn't help but notice, had maybe they left him alone to wallow in pity, you know, he would have never uncovered his secret power and been a non-factor in Mortal Kombat, but whatever. Who cares? Plot doesn't really matter. Let's just get on to the next fight. Now, I keep waiting for Mortal Kombat, and they keep saying, well, no Mortal Kombat this year, maybe next year, because they keep trying to stop Mortal Kombat from happening, which is pretty much what the villain's main goal is. Stop Mortal Kombat from happening, which I don't get. The only way they could actually defeat the Earthrealm is through Mortal Kombat. So they need Mortal Kombat to defeat in order to conquer the realm, but they don't want the fight to happen. I mean, it is rules, right? Apparently, conquest can only happen through this Mortal Kombat. So you would think that the villains would want Mortal Kombat, but instead they're trying to prevent it. I mean, the heroes don't seem to pose a threat. They won the last 9, yet they really fear this group of misfits. I mean, how bad were the last fighters in the last 9? They must have been horrible. So anyway, so they get together, they huddle up, and they're like, okay, we need to defeat these guys. The only way we can defeat them is by one-on-one. Now, I don't understand. Raiden knew where all of them were. Why didn't Raiden just take their fighters one by one and then gang up on them? Just bring them to his Shaolin Temple ring, have them defeat them by ganging up on them. Why do they need to fight one-on-one? They only have to fight one-on-one because, you know, the video game. So we have to make sure that they fight one-on-one. Jax fights this guy with a big club, which was a pretty good fight. That's when he unlocks his power. He turns his metal arms into super powerful metal arms. Okay, but anyway, keep moving. It's a fighting game movie. Who cares? Get to the next fight. So Jax unlocks his power, and then he crushes what's his face's head. Yay! Which was fun. I'd like to see it. Kung Lao was my favorite hero, because he did some really badass stuff with his spinny hat, and, you know, was pretty gory. Split the chicken too, which I thought was hilarious. Look at her. She's now twice the fun. And of course, Sonya goes and fights my favorite, Kano. And they take him to a trailer park, which a fight sequence happened in the bathroom, which I'm like, can you name me a background in the Mortal Kombat video game where they fight in a trailer bathroom and he fatalities someone with a gnome in the eye? But anyway, of course she was going to win. She beat him 3 times before that, so there was no tension for me. We knew she was going to win because she had already beat him. I know he had a laser eye, but which really only worked as a ranged weapon. Up close, that's a little harder to win. And they put them in a, and of course they put her in an advantage by putting her in a close quarter battle in her trailer. Hopefully, for her sake, Mortal Kombat pays well because she's got no home left. They really did a number on her washroom. She probably won't be able to take a crap for a while. Hopefully she can hold in. And of course, you got Lump of Coal now chasing Sub-Zero into another dimension, and he just happened to have set up this really cool icy battleground where he has his wife and child for some reason. I guess for motivation, but at that point, he was already motivated. Why did they need that? That's how bad of a character Cole is, that defending the world is not a good enough motivation to fight. Now, his motivation had to come personal, so whatever. And I don't know why he even bothered just freezing them. He didn't hesitate to kill Scorpion's family in the beginning, so why did he hesitate at the end? He grew soft in his old age. So he fights him, and of course he can't win on his own. And just as he's about to lose, Ex Machina Scorpion says, "Come over here!" And he resurrects from hell. Now I know they set up this whole sequence for Scorpion to be the hero. Now, I try to analyze this from a normal person's point of view. I mean, not a villain like me, but a normal human. A normal person would probably think someone who goes to hell is probably an evil person. You've done evil deeds in order to qualify for hell. So, they're both evil. So it's evil versus evil, I guess. So anyway, he conquered hell after 300 years and he decided to choose that exact moment. Scorpion, if nothing else, has a flair for the dramatic. So of course they gang up on Sub-Zero and whip his ass. Sorry, Sub-Zero, you're dead. It was a cool fatality by Scorpion. There was no emotional meaning towards that finale. I guess you're going back to hell now, Scorpion. And this guy is done now? His role is over? Is he gonna go back home and cry? Who knows? Who cares? And that's kind of what I felt about this film. A whole lot of jazzy action, which was fun, but without any emotion behind it. And I know that if you were a fan of the film, you had a lot of emotion. Oh my god, I'm so jazzed up by seeing all these nostalgic points. He said finish him! But from a standpoint of someone who doesn't know these characters, and I'm just watching it as a film, I have to say, it was fun to watch people fight and split people in two and burn each other to death. But let's be honest, there was no emotional stake in it for me, and I didn't care about any character, except for the one character I did care about a little bit, Kano, was pretty much a non-factor douchebag the whole movie long and died. Which is another problem. They killed off a lot of characters that I know from the video game took part in the tournament. Right? So now they're dead. They won't take part in the next tournament? I don't get it. Now if they bring them back, well then that's even worse because that means that there's no stake in this. So you can die and just be resurrected. Which we know probably is going to happen because otherwise a lot of the major characters you like won't take part in the tournament. I don't know. So what did I overall think? I thought the film was fun. If you could plop out your brain for a couple of hours and just watch it to just enjoy yourself, fine, it's alright. These kind of fighting video game movies, I guess you put it in the same category as Godzilla versus King Kong, you know? It's not gonna win any awards. It's not cinema, according to Scorsese, like I said. Could it have been a lot better? Of course. Yes, could have been way better. But the bar is so low on these type of films that it gets a pass because it was okay enough to be entertaining. I guess that could be enough, especially nowadays. I mean, there was no over-the-top political agenda, so... And today, in 2021, that's a win in of itself. Anyway, so that's what I thought of Mortal Kombat. You know, overall, I'd give it a 6 out of 10. Anyway, that's it. That's my review of Mortal Kombat. Bye-bye, Skeletor. Want to participate in Mortal Kombat? I'm interested to know what you how you think old Skeletor would do. In an actual fight, let me know what you thought of the film in the comments. Let me know what you'd like Skeletor to react to next. Oh, Skeletor, I pledge fealty to you as I, Sub-Zero, now at your bidding. I will join you, Skeletor, in your fight to defeat He-Man. Wonderful! I have a new ally. I like playing, don't judge me. I, Skeletor. I'm out. Yeah.